We'll get this thing going. Hey, how you doing? It's the Radio Bar and Grill, Party Party 102.1 FM, and in the studio, I got Rebecca Field, and I got Dina Mead, and I got a bunch of broken equipment today. It wasn't broken yesterday, so I don't know what the hell's going on. Anyway, how you girls doing? Talk into that when you talk.
Hi. How are you? Nice to be here. Wonderful to see you as always.
You got to talk into it. Don't go down on it. Just talk into it. There you
go. Well, you know how I am, though.
Yeah, I know.
You don't know
anyway,
me.
Yeah, it's all good.
So, Worldwide Pirate Radio.
All right. So we can see you on camera now, and we can see what you got going on. So we're having a show in here tonight. We got a bunch of bands playing, and I was out background music here for some reason. All my CD decks are dead, except this one. I'm not worried about it. Maybe it's Rebecca's CD. What'd you do to your CD?
No, it worked fine in the car.
Yeah, right.
I did get in a truck earlier, and I kind of probably sat on it, so oops.
I don't really care about your sex life. It's all good. Anyway, what we're trying to do is get it set up. So we got some live music tonight, and you guys want to talk about the program tomorrow, and we're doing a program today, so let's do this, and then we'll get it all figured out. You're on. Okay. Dina.
Well, next up we got Zig-Zag America. Jimmy Starr's on vocals. We got Mick Tabs on guitar, Jack Schaefer on bass, and Bo Garrow on drums. The band is actually out of Newport Richey. They were originally formed in 1993 by Jimmy and Mick. Current lineup has been since February of 2012. Please go to their website, check them out, all their new dates and everything at zigzagamerica.com.
All right, so we're going to hear from them in a few minutes, right? And then, but until then.
Well, we'll talk about the show a little bit. Dean and I had spoke many, many times. Dean and I have been friends for a long, long time, and I write a lot of original material. I've never really had the opportunity to play it out as much as I'd like to. I've been in a lot of cover bands, and I've been doing this most of my life, and I figured, well, let's go ahead and let's do some originals. Let's get some original showcases together. Let's support the local original musicians and music scene that kind of has fallen on the wayside over the years. You know, people seem to not support it as much as they used to, and we want to try and bring that back. So with that being said, we kind of put our heads together, and Dina does a lot of promoting. She's always been wonderful at that and helped me out many, many times. And so we put this together. Actually, she's done all the work. I just have the mouth. And we're going to be doing this tomorrow at Screwy Louis Porpoise Pub. The address, please. Oh, do I have the address? I don't have that. Well, anyway, you just find it. It's in St. Pete. I don't have that.
It's actually in Seminole, honey.
Oh, that
Seminole
same place.
Boulevard.
St. Pete, Seminole. It's all the same. Just go down Seminole, you get St. Pete. I mean, it runs through all these counties. You know it does.
It's Keith. He's messing y'all up.
Yeah, this is Little Keith, by the way. LKW, Little Keith Wilkins in the house, bitches. Now, and for those of you who know Keith Wilkins, apparently you don't know me. I'm Keith Wilkins, bitches.
And it's a conspiracy theory, of course.
And it's all a conspiracy, but Keith's here. He's going to be interviewing Jeff Vitolo and his new band,
Quarter Mile Rebels.
And I found this this little guy today, and Keith, I think maybe there was another son. I don't know that your mom ever told you, but I think that now you know. And he's actually a little smaller than you. Who knew? You know, shit. So anyway, what we're doing anyway, we've got how many bands are going on tomorrow? She knows everything that's going on. I don't, but I just act like I do.
Tomorrow, 6 bands going on. We start out with Kenny McGee and Marcus Lee that are doing an unplugged version. Now, I just got a phone call from Marcus today saying that their drummer might be there as well. So that
well,
might
he's
actually
gotta pay.
Be that he's
yeah,
got to pay to be there.
To get in, yeah.
But we've got 6 bands, 10 acts total. It's going to be a great day. Open jam starts around 8-ish, of course, where everything's on schedule and working well, but you know, we all know how this goes. So now Keith's taking pictures. But anyhow, we've got a great lineup tomorrow. We've got Kenny McGee, Marcus Lee Unplugged. During the 20-minute break, we've got Buddy King that's actually going to be doing a solo acoustic. After that, we've got Diamond Gray playing a full 45-minute set, and then we've got Jason Tosmack. He's going to be doing acoustic. We've got Buddy King, Shotgun Junkies, and that's actually their debut performance tomorrow.
And the Pistols.
And the pistols,
and
of
the
course, because they're the sexy bitches.
That's what it is.
Can't forget them.
Girls.
And then, of
girls.
Course, after that, you know, Kevin had to stick his nose in, so we got third story basement going on right before Undercover Betty.
Kevin Keene could not get left out.
I know.
He can't get left out.
Yep, I know. Well, you know, he usually calls my phone just to get to you when we're together.
I know.
After that, we got Dark Savant doing an acoustic act. Zig-Zag's coming on after that. During the break, Lee Pons is going to do his one-man show. And then we got Tommy Rocks and Big Deal. Then we're going right into Open Jam. So it ought to be a good day. Starts
did
at
you
1:30.
Say Undercover Betty?
Yes.
Oh, just kidding. I'm
said,
kidding.
She didn't say. No. No, she didn't. She didn't say Undercover Betty.
I said Kevin Keeney.
Actually, everywhere
third story basement was going on before Undercover Betty.
Oh, see.
Just
see.
Aggravate her.
I thought we had Undercover Betty in here, so we were supposed to be nice.
That's right.
I don't have to be nice to her. She's like one of my besties.
You know, every time it seems like when we play, it's always raining, so we're underwater, Betty, most of the time. It's just always raining. Last night, monsooning.
Yeah, we dealt with that last night, too, and I'm afraid we're going to deal with that tonight, tomorrow, and the next damn day, because I just looked at the weather a little while ago, and it's still raining. It's not raining here, though, so if you're out there and you're not down here, now it's time to get down here, because, you know, we got this going on.
And please, women, wear white T-shirts when you come.
Yes, and no bra.
Or an undercover Betty
and
shirt.
Because that gets little Kevin excited there.
Keith.
Oh, sorry,
Kevin, Keith, they're all the same.
I forgot. Yeah, it doesn't
I'd
matter.
Like to thank Kevin Teresa. Keith. Oh, shit. I just dropped him. You're dead,
yeah,
little Keith.
You're down there. Yeah, okay.
I'd like to thank Teresa for making the glasses. They're very well made. She's quite an artist.
Yeah, she is.
She
you're not as usually as tinted as Keith fucking Wilkins' glasses.
Go ahead, let us know.
Well, right. Keith's got the glasses and, you know, so
to and now. A press pass. Of
and,
course.
Yeah, banned all access,
Keith
of course.
Wilkins, you know. Apparently you don't know me. Apparently I'm with the Historical Center and Society.
Oh,
thank you
God
very much.
Almighty.
And the Hall of Fame. Pet me on my head. I'm short. It'll work.
Kiss my ass. Apparently. Okay, so let's kick this off, shall we? Are the guys ready out there?
Absolutely.
Are they
want to
play now, you think?
Well, if they want to.
We got Zig-Zag America going to be playing up in here. And you know, until then, we'll get them all set up. I'll get, what we got? Undercover Betty on this thing that's
little
skipping.
Keith's staring at me really weird right now, okay? I'm feeling a little bit violated.
Let's see if this thing plays, and then we'll bring on Zig-Zag America then.
Undercover Betty music. Yeah, so, that's right.
Is this Undercover Betty or just Rebecca?
Well, that's all of us. Rebecca with Undercover Betty.
That is Rebecca. It sounds like you.
She's a sexy bitch.
She is a sexy bitch. I'm glad. All right, we're going to listen to this. And not
I know. Little Keith's looking at me. Little Keith, where are you going? Little Keith!
Oh, he's down there. He's got to get him some of it. Look at that. He's a cougar shooter.
A cougar shooter?
I can't believe that. You got his whole damn head down in there.
You know, I knew I'd be embarrassed by the song.
Nice. All right, so enjoy this. While the band gets tuned up, we'll have Zig-Zag America up in a minute. Listen to the skips. This is a great CD. Thanks for bringing it in.
Okay,
we appreciate it.
Thanks for playing all the skips.
Well, she has it cracked it. It would have been playing perfectly. I forgot to tell her it has a crack in it. How many times have I got to tell you girls crack kills?
All the time, every time.
Right.
Again and again and again and again.
Anyway, we'll be right back here with Zig-Zag America on the Party Fire. Stay tuned for a minute, and then we'll listen to the crack CD.
To avoid another crash, and all that I have to say, the time for words have passed. Balance is exceeded.
Then went like, there you go.
That
what was Undercover Betty in it?
That was called Skip. That song's called Skip.
No, yeah, right. Well, I think now this down into the part of the CD that's not cracked that Dina didn't sit her butt on. It is what it is. So, anyway, what I've got lined up for you, ladies and gentlemen, is right here. Can you guys hear me out there? Just talking to the microphone so I can hear you in here.
Hey,
you can hear me out there, right?
I can hear you out here louder than I can hear me.
Well, you're not going to hear yourself. I told you, I don't like bands, so I don't turn their damn level up. Give me a second. What we got, Dina, go ahead and introduce the band again. It's
Zig-Zag America.
Yeah, Zig-Zag America. I said Zig-Zag America. You know,
tell me where it is. But I can add that Nikki Zarnacki is going to be taking a lot of band pictures tonight. She's offered her time. That's nice.
Zig-Zag America. Zig-Zag America.
All right, we're going to quit screwing around now. I'm gonna put them on. Give yourself 2 seconds so I can get your level up. And ladies and gentlemen, stay tuned. And a big round of applause for Zig-Zag America. Thank you.
That was too much level.
I know, too much level. Right. You got your level now.
Yep. Yeah. Hey, yeah. You guys ready in there? You guys in there?
Olicka.
Yeah. Hey.
My girl from Undercover Betty in the house, Connor.
Yeah.
How you doing, Connor?
Hey.
Hey, girl.
All right, you guys ready for some Zig-Zag America? Check it out.
Right, it was glad to get rid. You want a real day, got a roaring on your head. room of a baby, let's go for a ride. That's what I said, I said go for a ride. Put the radio blasting, I'm popping my teeth. But number three, let's up it in my ear, sounds great. Well, the next thing you know it, I look to the right. Cause I'm a speed demon, I gotta keep it moving faster. Cause I'm a speed demon, driving up the road is such a disaster. Well, I'm a speeder, it's 125. Making sure I'm alone, it's time to decide. I don't just dog it, I put my foot to the floor. It's out where my fun must be more fun. So I'm smoking my smoke, it's sipping my wine. The steps will go to death, I must be blind. Well, I know where I'm going and I know what to do. Yeah, the road's got shorter, but it's slowed down too. Cause I'm a speed demon, it's moving faster. Cause I'm a speed demon, turning off the road, it's hard to disaster. From the sun and right in front of me, I swim to miss out big and I hit a fucking tree. My friend is dead and now I'm ghost sweetheart. Clear up in the habit where I'll be fine. So I'm telling you the story so you'll understand. You gotta keep on running for your wicked man. You know that sometimes you win, you know sometimes you lose. What the hell you want from me? It's just the way it goes. Cause I'm a sweet demon, keep it moving faster. Cause I'm a speed demon, driving up the road, it's hard to disaster. I'm a speed demon, I gotta keep it moving faster. Cause I'm a speed demon, driving up the road, it's hard to disaster. Driving up the road, it's hard to disaster. Driving up the road, it's all to disaster. Sweet demon, sweet demon, sweet demon, sweet demon.
Radio bar, are we starting to warm things up for you in here? Come on.
Tight jeans, bright blue eyes stare right at me. Long hair, this winter scene. Baby, can you feel how she's hot? Jimmy, you know you can't give me just what I need. I said, baby, you drive me crazy. Just you wait and see, just you wait and see. Baby, where you go? Baby, where you going now? Baby, where you going? Baby, where you going? Baby, where you going now? Hot ass, long legs, she's looking real hard. Got me out of my hair. Sweet smell, she's hitting my way. Jonah, can you feel her? She's had Jimmy, no, you can't give me just what I need. I said, baby, you drive me crazy. Just you wait and see, just you wait and see. Baby, where you going now? Baby, where you going now? Baby, where you going? Baby, where you going? Baby, where you going now? We'll be right back.
Is there any way I can get anything to hear myself at all here? Please. No. Once I come here, I can hear these. No. Not at all. It ain't loud enough.
Hey, yeah. Yeah, hey, yeah.
Everywhere you play, no monitors.
That's what happens. That's my fault.
Yeah, hey, hey, yeah, hey, yeah, hey. Check it out. Hey, hey. States of America, and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. I see the world is changing, there's no time to mess around. While you're sitting there complaining, we're taking back the style. We live by the balls and stripes, we'll protect it with our life. Oh yeah. By serving our country, that's what keeps us free. Yes, it does. There's no easy way out. We have to fight for what we believe in, and we will do it without a doubt. Because we are American. Let's keep this country free.
tribes. We're protected with our lives. By serving our country, that's what keeps us free. Yes, it does.
Yeah, we're all American, you know what I'm saying? Thank you very much. Doing the best I can up here for you. I found a sweet spot right there, just in case you're wondering. All right, this one is track 4 on the album. We've been in the studio Tuesday. We're going to finish up the vocal tracks on this, and then it gets mixed, mastered, packaged. Then we'll have it for you. It'd be cool. Till then, you can check it out on zigzagamerica.com. Again, track 4. This is Coming Back to You. Girl, you know you're gonna be the one. I'm so glad that I found you. You know when I died, Miguel, I knew it would never end. They say that our lives have changed. Let's stop it, rearrange. Girl, I miss you. Been away, God, stay God, change. Yeah. Thank you. All right, this is called So Close.
Loaded guns to goblin slaves. Time to kill. Flags are raised. M16 strapped on his back. His best friend isn't coming back. Fight for life, you're on your own. Learn the truth, there's no one home. So close, so far away. All around, see yourself lying on the ground. Count the deaths in your platoon. The end is near and you hope it's soon. Pray to God, please take your life. Can't take the pain of this deadly night. As you lie there on your back, scared to death, a heart attack. Bullets flying through the air. Bombs are burning over there. This be time to say goodbye. The time. It's time to die. So close but so far away. I had it all in my hands today. I had a good grip but then it slipped away. Because I'm so close but so far away. Come on. The gun up to his head, pulls the trigger, now he's dead. From the start is where I'll be. Now you know this sick story. And now he says from way up there, war just sucks, it's so unfair. Presidents who take control all should die, nowhere to go. Bullets flying through the air. Bombs are burning over there. There's no time to say goodbye.
Yeah. thinking and then stand.
Okay.
All right, check it out. Jump off course here. We call this thinking. You got no more double bass. Everything else is really. Because you break that thing up like that. These house kids, you know, they can't take Big Bo back here, you know what I'm saying? Check it out. We wrote this from a poem my daughter wrote. Sometimes I want to run away, away from home. I can sometimes feel my life is not so bad. Body's twisting, turns out no pain. I need to go to my own world where life's just so simple and easy. Everyone just really girls. I want to know what the people are thinking. I'm not a person like me. I believe in living a life at
living it free.
I want to know what the people are thinking. I'm not a person like me. I believe in living
life
and living it free.
People are thinking about a person like
living a dream. Oh, I know what the people all thinking about a person like
Jake.
Me. I believe
not
in
Jack.
Living
Jake
life
Schaefer.
And living it free. I wanna know what the people all thinking about a person like me. I believe in living life and living it free.
Yeah, Radio Bar. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
get here today. Sat here today. Thank you very much.
I can do more.
One more.
Gin and juice.
Oh. Whoa. Go ahead, Jake.
Oh, are you serious?
All right.
We're going to tomorrow, aren't
we? Oh, yeah.
All right, we're going to do it. Wait. I want to tell these guys something, though. The reason we're here is we're going to try to get you to the Screwy Louie's Porpoise Pub tomorrow. Tomorrow they're doing an original band gathering. I see a few people that I recognize from, you know, social networks. So we're trying to build up the crowd over there. You want to see some more Zig-Zag America? We got a whole bunch of tricks up our sleeves. We're the original band from Newport Richie. You can check out our shit on zigzagamerica.com. But this next song is actually a cover song. See if you recognize this.
he said Sweet Leaf.
Drama in the LBC, my heartbeat's the D-O-double-G. But I somehow, some way, keep coming up in funky ass shit like every single day. And I kick a little something for the G's and make it through match through the breeze. Through 2 in the morning, cause my party's still jumping, cause my mama is home. I got bitches in the living room getting it on, and they ain't leaving till 6 in the morning. Do what you wanna do, shit. I got a pocket full of rubbers and my homeboys do too. So turn off the lights and close the doors. But what? We don't love them whores. So we can smoke an ounce today. D's up, O's down, while your motherfuckers bounce today. Rolling down the street, smoking my endo, sipping on gin and juice. Uh-oh, laid back. Money on my mind, money on my mind. Money on my mind.
My life
so I got
after
me some Seagrams and Jim. Everybody's got their cups, but they ain't chipped in. Now this type's of shit happens all the time. You gotta get yours before I gotta get mine.
My
everything is fine
now.
If you listen to the DOD, I got the cultivate
real
music that they captivate me. Who listens to the words that I say as I take me a drink in the middle of the street? I got me a bitch named Sadie. She used to be that homeboy's lady.
Oh, that bitch.
80 degrees when I tell the bitch please. Get out some rap times, I get none of these at ease. As I ride with the dog pound, feel the breeze and I'll be jumping down. Rolling down the street, smoking my endo, sipping on gin and juice. Uh-oh, lean back. Party on my mind, party on my mind. Body on my mind. Money on my mind. Money on my mind.
Three people don't know what you're about. They put you down and shut you out.
Money
you
on my
gave
mind
to me a new belief.
Money
and soon the world will love you sweetly.
When I first met
later
you
on that day,
My homie got the drink, came through with a guy, the tiger ray. Up down, I skid, a song of comics and products. I got the shit, if that the shit ain't no joke, I got the balance of all my sin. Set my cup down, tap away, chronic, yeah, I'm fucked up now. I'm here, ain't stopping, I'm still popping. Dre's got the business from the city of Boston to serve me, not with a cherry on top. Cause when I bust a nut, I rise above the god girl. But don't get upset, girl, it's just how it goes. We don't love them whores, and I'll be rolling down the street, smoking my endo, sipping on gin and jills. Only back, body on my mind, body on my mind. Rolling down the street, smoking endo, sipping on gin and jills. Only back, money on my mind, money. It's like a doobie trying to do me off the rail. Yeah, boom.
What time is it, Dina?
He's beating the shit out of this drum set back here. It ain't holding up. He's a big guy, you know. Is it all over the place? What I'm supposed to do? Why don't you think that I would listen to you? I try to tell her time and time again. Oh, why don't you see that you're not going? Did my chances go from blue to white? And I wish you're here, everything's alright. Why don't you have a different point of view? Oh, I thought you should have thought it through. Did my chances go for good tonight? And I wish you'll hear everything's alright. Did my chances go for good tonight? If I wish you'll hear everything's alright. And I wish you how everything's alright. Oh, my chances go far broken tonight. And I wish you how everything's alright. Alright, alright, alright.
Yeah. All right. Unfortunately, that's it. You want to see some more Zig-Zag America? It'll be tomorrow at Screwy Louie's. Thank you very much.
All right, well, there you go. That's Zig-Zag America. Give him one more round of applause, huh? What do you say? Come on, let's hear it for him. I don't know. Y'all ain't clapping a lot. They're going to play another one. They said they had to leave at 9 anyway, but they had 5 more minutes, and I guess you guys just didn't make enough noise. Anyway, we're going to keep the party going on here at the Radio Bar and Grill. We got more live music. And we're trying to talk to Rebecca Field and see if she's going to go up there and play something or what. I don't even see her anymore. She's probably in the parking lot. Whatever. So if we can get that going, until then, we don't have to get it going. I got some canned music up here. We can do that. Stay tuned for more here. All right, how you guys doing out there tonight? It is the Party Pirate 102.1 FM, WPRN, and the Radio Bar and Grill. And in here, I've got Rebecca Field and Kana from Undercover Betty. And, of course, Zig-Zag America. I just had this band on stage just a moment ago. So how you guys doing?
Not too bad.
All right, good. I'm just getting the levels up here, so to make sure the mics are where they're supposed to be again. It is what it is. You know, rock and roll is a tough business.
Especially original band is a way tough business.
Damn it. And, you know, having a dirty pot doesn't help either.
Dirty what?
You know, pot. You know what you smoke?
It's 420. That's right. That's right.
It's a 420 show.
It's a 420 amp show.
Yeah.
You know, we get it right.
Yeah.
So, how long have you been together?
Me and Mick were in a band, and we were Zig-Zag for 16 years. We separated for a while, and then we got back together, switched around. Mick actually played bass when we were Zig-Zag that long ago.
We're the only two original members left.
Yeah.
That's all you need, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Obviously,
yeah.
You kept going. You know, sometimes there is a core. There's such thing as a core.
Yeah.
You have to weed out the bad ones. And
yeah. Well, it was almost at least like 10 years I hadn't even talked to Jimmy.
Yeah.
Or seen him.
Really?
He moved away. And then Facebook is an amazing thing. I mean, you find all these people that you haven't seen in 30 years, you know.
But when me and Mick get together,
that was like
man, it's amazing.
So the reunion of the band and you guys playing together is like a social networking thing or something, right?
Yeah, it's crazy.
That's kind of weird.
That's why we named the album .com.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, because it's, you know, the day of the .com.
It is. It's
RadioBar.com.
Yeah, you know.
ZigZagAmerica.com.
Everything's .com.
UndercoverBetty.com.
Oh, yeah. Right. We had to have the .com, but we'd have to change our name to, like, Dillweed or something. I mean, we weren't sure.
You're talking to Mike. Here.
Thank you. Oh,
don't go down on it. I know it's round and black, but you know.
But no, you know, how wonderful that there are these websites that actually can connect you back, reconnect you with friends, and so you were the original two then, and and went through members,
like,
and then
93, and then
played all over
2010 before we actually reunited again.
And where are you based out of?
Newport Richey.
Okay. Oh, you're up in my neck of the woods.
Yeah.
All right. We were at Sandbar last night. Yay, Sandbar. Marcy at Sandbar. Go, girl.
All right. All right.
Great stuff. And where are you playing? What's your next gig? Where are you playing? Other than, of course, Porpoise Pub tomorrow. This is what we're doing this for.
Memorial Day party coming up.
Yeah.
Those are always fun.
And
The singer from the Platters House or something has invited
really?
Us.
Can I come? I'll set up your gear.
Yeah, he said we can invite who we want.
Really?
So.
I'm a great guitar roadie.
Mickey Mouse in the backyard.
Yeah, he's got a pool, all kinds of different themes and all. I don't know. It's supposed to be some big.
And you get paid too.
Either way, it don't matter to
just
me. You know those gigs. You know,
sure, absolutely.
Just wanting to get the music out there.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes it doesn't pay to get paid in what we're doing. You know what I mean? Just go out on the corner and shake a tambourine and sing. You know.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I tried that once. You know, and I went to Ybor like that, and then they told me I had to buy a $275 permit to sit out there.
I had to bail him out. Remember the night you called me? Yeah, I'm in jail.
Yeah, I know.
We didn't have a drummer for a while. We played to a drum machine.
Did you really?
We just wrote and wrote to a drum machine, wrote and wrote to a drum machine, and then we can play all our songs acoustic. Every one of
them. And that's nice.
Yeah.
When you can cross over and do that, you know you've arrived. Because
there's
a lot of songs that people write, and I mean, there's nothing wrong with this, but to be able to refine it to an acoustic stage is special.
Where it starts a lot is on
and
acoustic.
It absolutely is, because a lot of songs that I have written actually started on acoustic and then they end up heavier, and to be able to pull it back and really get a whole different feel out of it is really cool. You know, then you have two albums. You don't have to write and all that extra music.
Like
now you release the acoustic unplugged version of the same album.
Yes.
I say album.
If you already recorded it, it doesn't really matter, right?
That's right.
The song American we did tonight, we just wrote that like 3 weeks ago. Good. We've only played that probably 4 or 5 times. And I screwed it up again tonight. I forgot to go
Well, nobody knew. You guys sounded great. I was going to say, you know, you guys sounded really good in here. And I hope the fans enjoyed it. I know you had a lot of listeners. You still got a lot of listeners online. If you want to say anything to the listeners and the people that are viewing you now, they can see you on camera in the studio here. So,
awesome.
You know.
Yeah, keep supporting, you know, local bands, you know, keep listening to everybody's original music, you know, artists, you know, we write, and all we don't want to do is share it with y'all, you know, and that's why we do it, and we like to see the smiles on your face, and the movement in your bodies, and the taking the ride with us, you know, that's the coolest part of the whole thing.
It is. You know? It's just so wonderful when you see a reaction from the audience, and you see people singing to your songs, and asking you for a certain original, and you kind of, and there's times when I go, you want to hear what, and they say an original song, and you know, and a name of a certain original song, and then you realize, wow, you know, people do listen. And I find it very unfortunate, and nothing against any of the cover bands, because my gosh, I've been in cover bands all my life.
Yeah.
But to not play an original song, to not really play an original song, and there's a lot of great bands out there that are cover bands, great Tampa Bay, you know, bass bands.
Awesome bands.
I wish they would play originals. I wish they would at least spend some time.
Come up with something good, you know.
Right. Learn something.
I think I'm drinking Dina's beer. Is this Dina's beer?
Yeah, write something. It's important, because you never feel, it's a complete different feeling of applause when you get applause from an original song compared to a cover standard song that everybody's played, and you can go to every bar any given day of the week and hear the same song over and over. People are going to clap because they're drunk.
Respect.
You know, and they respect you,
and they
or whatever.
Love
and
songs. They already hear them on the radio and stuff all the time. So.
But to get applause from your own your own stuff is beyond.
And you know, that feeling lasts all the night. Mm-hmm. It goes into the next day.
Oh, it does.
And
see,
you talk to each other.
Oh,
wasn't that so cool? You know, and it just never stops.
Yeah, but that's what music's all about. You know, creativity and you know, something that you got talent. You know, you go out there and you put something together, and people like it. Then, what do you think the guys feel like? They're like the Beatles. You know, people have sold 1 billion records. Think about it. You know, they must be like, hey. People love us.
Yeah.
But it's a lot of hard work. People don't see behind the scenes what it takes to make a show happen and to make and make music sound good. Yeah.
And what's really cool is like people like yourself taking the time to actually talk with us and talk with ladies like that, writing their own music and sharing it with the people. This is what it takes for people to listen nowadays, you know?
Well, and for that reason, too, is why, and thank you, Craven, for allowing us to come in here and express ourselves and and being a part of this and supporting this. It means, and of course, you and I, him and I have known each other probably all our lives. I mean, this is not just a new friendship here. This is not, I didn't say nude.
Oh,
I was waiting for you to come in on that one, but you
nude
didn't.
Sometimes.
See,
I was going to say,
but
only sometimes.
This is
nude.
Not a new friendship. We've known each other for many years, and he is a wonderful guy. And we want everything to work. We want this bar to work. We want the whole network radio to work.
Through the glass.
And bringing in the original music and allowing people to come in and express themselves, you know, is wonderful. Thank you for letting us do that. Thank you so much. We appreciate your help.
Because I know
we
the
love
fans,
you got
your people out there listening, knowing that you're out there, and they're in here, they're tuned into the broadcast now, and they've seen you play, and that's what it's all about.
Right on.
I mean, you know, and you can get so many people in a venue, but this is worldwide.
Worldwide.
And
you know, all over the United States, not
even,
just Florida.
You know, when you all these places you play, I mean, it's everybody has different equipment. You know what I mean? And it's always a struggle with the equipment.
It is.
And just keep pushing forward and push. I'm playing anyway.
You guys handled it beautifully.
We know what we say. We always used to say back in the day, and I've been doing it a long time, but I used to say the show's got to go on. The show must go on,
and that's very important.
And if you're not able to do that, you're not thick-skinned enough, and you need to get out. Right. You know, there are some people that aren't cut out for it, but those of us that are, we've had a hell of a ride.
Yeah.
And it's been great, and it still keeps getting better, doesn't it?
It does get better.
Doesn't it get better?
It gets better and better.
All positive.
Yeah, you know, it's...
Oh, hello, look, it's Dina Mead.
Yeah. Is this your beer?
Yeah, he's over there drinking your beer.
Jimmy's drinking your beer, honey.
It doesn't matter.
He just stuck his tongue in it. What
kind of beer? No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
He did it on purpose.
I did it. Here, he lipped the rim.
He's going to spew the beer all over the damn board.
No, I just want to know, considering this is actually being recorded onto the thumb drive, that...
What?
Dear Mr. Ponzi Pants, you were supposed to be over here before now. Now you're riding with Buddy King, and you guys are fucking late. And so now we got to talk more. And so...
What did you say, late or lame?
Here's the problem with Lee Ponzarelli Panzeroni, okay?
Lee Ponzarelli Panzeroni?
He thinks he's in Pantera. Obviously, he's a rock star. So when he comes in here, we will treat him as one.
No, right. We won't.
Well, no, we will. Don't worry, we will. And Lee, if you're listening,
sure,
hurry up and get over here, or else somebody's going to take your place quickly. And it might be me.
I'm thinking
if I get
an
acoustic
do.
Guitar, your stage position is gone, Lee, and you can turn around and go home.
Yeah, wow. And I got this other guitar out.
Love
here.
You.
We make this happen.
Wow.
we'll put anybody
girls
on stage.
Girls are brutal.
Oh, no, Lee's been my friend for 30 years. I can say what I want to Lee.
Yeah, he's like a last minute kind of guy.
Oh, no.
Lee, are you kidding me? He's still brushing his something.
Well, that's a lot of rock starishness going on.
You know, Lee Pons is a wonderful guy. We love him. He's on his way.
I'm
but I have to
though.
Mess with him. It's
really
okay that I do. And Buddy
really
King, I haven't seen in years. So,
my hands are
but they're still late, and that's not good.
Well, you know, sometimes when you're a rock star, you don't ever, you know, get there on time or whatever. So
I'm
it is what it
beer.
Is.
Leave it to me. Okay.
You're still late.
All right. So they're still late. Did you? Nice.
No.
All right, Dina, you got anything else you wanted to say before we? I'm gonna put some more music back on, and I might just play Rebecca Fields' stuff here.
Yeah,
while I'm setting
stuff.
Her up, I'm gonna
don't
go plug her into
stuff.
Something and make her play something.
How are you gonna do that? That's
no,
shit
I want to make sure that you guys know that over here outside is Nikki taking pictures. Anybody, you know, band wise, if you need some band pictures, she's awesome. Very fair. Probably come out there and just, you know, pay her some gas money or something. Give her a soda.
Will you give me my partner?
And what?
Can I have my partner?
Oh, wait. Let me give her a partner. Hold on. It's little Keith.
Little Keith is...
But, anyway, if you need band pictures, please make sure you give, you know, get her card from her, because she was gracious enough to come out this evening, and take pictures for us all night, which will be posted on Facebook tomorrow. And so, you know, help her out, too. We're kind of networking everybody, from photographers to bands to Craven to everybody.
And we work on it. If you keep going, you know, you're going to make it happen. If you don't keep going, then you just fade away.
He's kind of gay at times.
Yeah, he's kind of gay.
Oh, yeah, at all times.
No! See, holy shit!
No, actually, I think he goes... He was in Rebecca's crotch a minute ago, and now he's over
Keith.
There.
And ladies and gentlemen, smoke. Keith Wilkins.
So he goes both ways, I guess. I don't know. I'm not going to start now. All right,
so. Go ahead, Keith.
They look alike.
No, I'm just in here supervising to make sure to see, you know, I'm just trying to do damage control, but I realize
that you
two.
But apparently, brother, you're not.
Excuse me, Mr. Heath Willens.
It's the little brother I always never wanted.
It's the mini-me thing, you know, whatever it is.
Actually, Keith's wife, ex-wife, texted him. His first ex-wife.
Yeah, which ex-wife?
Him.
You know, I've
Jenny,
you know.
His okay. first yeah. ex-wife, texted him earlier and said, "I'm
whore.
Sorry, he's a whore, and I actually didn't even realize he had a little brother."
No, I don't exactly remember the text message reading exactly that way.
That's
Dina.
What you told me.
No, I don't recall anybody
that's
saying that my
it,
ex-wife
so
called
off.
Me a whore.
Oh, you're a big whore.
Now we know everybody's a whore.
Apparently. You
apparently.
Don't know me.
Apparently, you don't understand this, Mr. Heath Wilson.
Leave it to Limey.
All right, so there you go. Rebecca Field has left the building, and now I guess we're gonna put a little bit more music on. I'm gonna see if I can get Rebecca up here to play something, because we got some people that are late. I'm not gonna mention any names. Was it Ponzarelli or Ponzarelli? Anyway.
It's Ponzi Pants.
Ponzi Pants
is Mr. out.
Lee Ponzi Pants.
Okay. So we're gonna see what happens. If I can get Rebecca here to play anything, it would be really fantastic because she's
happen.
Like one of the best, I'm
we're
telling
doing
you.
It. Hell yeah.
Rebecca's amazing.
All right, give me a minute. I'll put a little bit of background music on and then we'll get back to the broadcast here. So stay tuned here. It's the Radio Bar and Grill, WPRN, DB Tampa, Florida.
Really
and hey, 102.1 FM, so stay tuned. We'll get something going.
Wait a minute. I want a little key.
Okay. Are you taking
the
key?
Can I have
them? You guys want to just do a set and then do the interview? Is that what you're going to
do? Well, you know, first of all,
couple of songs,
they're not getting an interview.
We have a lot of shit to talk about.
Oh, they're not getting an interview? Oh, okay.
No, they were late.
Is this thing work?
Yeah, we'll in a second. All right, let me get it for you. Hold on.
Lee Ponzarelli Panzeroni. Late again.
Well, there we go. There you go.
I'll get it up. I'll get the level up
you
there
know,
for you.
I know that you guys, you know, being in Pantera.
Are you still talking? Are you talking still? I'm sorry, who are you?
You don't know me.
No.
You don't know me.
You don't know me.
I don't know you.
You know, all of a sudden, Lee is like,
I love Rebecca.
Mr. Ponzi Pants.
She sings.
Shut the hell up.
She can sing. She can
go with it. I'm the baby sister. Shh.
What?
Don't piss me off.
Who
I'll
is
have
that?
To kick your fucking ass. It's me, Dina.
Rebecca,
asshole.
How'd you do that without moving your lips? All four of them.
Yeah, that's the ones that you can't see right now are the ones that everybody loves.
Is that the one that they're moving?
Yeah, I tell you, I know I've known Rebecca forever. She's really, really horny is when you stick her
you
hand down her pants, it feels like you're feeding the horse.
You know? Don't know me.
that's you know she's really horny.
Get out of Boston, man.
Hold on. Is it like this?
I'm so in trouble.
Like this.
Thanks, Craven.
It's Keith.
Oh, I see Kevin's in the studio, too.
It's little Keith. Keith Wilson.
Oh, Keith. No,
Keith
I always
Wilson.
Call him Kevin.
Mr. Wilkinson.
Little Keith.
I was thinking about your husband.
Little
No, that's Kevin.
So
speaking
anyway,
of low
look
blows.
At the new rocks. Let's talk about Tommy Rocks. Okay, thanks, Tommy. Bye. Actually, no, Tommy Rocks, we really meant to play a lot of original material tonight.
Keep playing
and
that guitar, though.
I got to
get a level on it. Hold
this
on.
This is a preamp show for tomorrow's Porpoise Pub gig, all original show. And we had Diamond Gray, Tommy Rocks, give us submit CDs, Kenny McGree, and then who's this? Lee.
Play it again.
Lee Fuckwad.
I'll get the bass, too.
Fuck that guy.
Ponzi
anyway,
Pants.
That's you know,
Pants.
And we're sorry that we didn't get around to playing those CDs.
Rebecca, aren't you playing tomorrow, too?
What?
Are you playing tomorrow?
She says
seriously,
she's playing.
Seriously.
Yes.
Really.
Rebecca,
you're
not
a CD?
Paying attention to me.
I have a CD. It's in the player right now. We took yours out to play my stuff.
Let's hear it.
You really
Let's
want to?
It's all right.
It could happen.
Right
no,
now.
That's all right, Lee. You've already wasted enough time being late. Don't even try to drag it on any longer. You're going on, okay?
Oh, you can make anything
on.
Happen.
I don't know. See, this is the way he does this.
I want to hear Rebecca's CD.
I got your
CD.
Number, buddy.
That is Rebecca's CD.
Those are little sound effect CDs.
It only skips because I suck my ass on it. I'm sorry.
Said it sounds like that sound effects CD with the cats.
I thought it was actually. I'm sorry. My fault. I didn't realize. I'm sorry.
You don't want me to start shredding you, dude. Really? You don't want me to start.
We're talking about
I love you.
Trust
Every
me,
time he calls you, he's got a big old cock in his mouth.
12 years.
I love you.
I know all your jokes. I got backups for them. But I love you too, baby.
I love you. Thank you.
I love you, baby. Dina's a little sis.
Ponzi Pants, my back is...
Rebecca is my big sis.
Baby's in the corner. Baby's in the corner.
Can I get some mic over here, guys?
Oh, wait.
These guys
Buddy
gonna,
wants
like,
mic now.
Gonna
yeah, I'll get it up there for
you
in a second.
We should get Buddy on mic because he's the one singing. There.
Lee, did you actually write this or did you sequence it?
What's that?
Did you write this or did you steal the sequence?
I'll get out there and fix that for you in a second.
Both.
I've noticed you didn't say shit.
I said both.
I knew it.
I said both.
He said bopus. All right, I'll get your mic for you there in a second. I just, I got to come out there to the submixer and do it.
Oh, my God, Diamond Gray never sounded so good.
she, you know what? She's in here, and now she's been had. You guys had your way with her.
Listen up, learn how to write a song, Lee. Here you go. Here. That's how you do it.
Where'd you lose your wings? I'm just standing here with my arms out wide, hoping that you
you got anything that's written this century? We played that song, 12 years ago? I love you.
Yeah, Bob.
Let's do it. Come on, man. Don't be scared.
I'm a liar. I'm a liar of the worst kind. I'm a liar. 'Cause I lied to myself. I tell myself she's coming home tonight. Everything's gonna be alright. But I'm a liar. I'm a liar of the worst kind, yeah. I'm a liar. 'Cause I lied to myself. I tell myself everything's gonna be alright, yeah. I tell myself I won't be alone tonight. But I'm a liar. Lee Pons on bass. It will be okay. I tell myself that I'm loved. I tell myself that I'll rise above. But I'm a liar. A liar of the worst kind, yeah. I'm a liar. Myself.
ain't nobody loves you as you stare through me. But everybody loves you, you're just too blind to see. This could be your lucky day, those people won't know what to say, yeah. Smother you in kisses. Gonna smother you in kisses. You said I'm fame, you're dealing pain. Your attitude's so cold, every step in vain. Won't be but a soul. This could be your lucky day. This probably your lucky day, yeah. This is probably your lucky day. This is definitely your lucky day, yeah. Yay!
Yesterday's wine.
Yeah.
much, 'cause you do not exist for me.
Called Invisible. That's about like my last four relationships. They all lasted at least 4 days. How about a little tribute to Johnny Cash? You guys like Johnny Cash? Anybody in here? Yeah? All right, this is a Trent Reznor song that Johnny Cash re-recorded. And it was released right after his death. So we're going to do this as our way, as a tribute to
Johnny.
It was
posthumous.
Can I get just a little more volume on that guitar, possibly?
Thank you.
Thank you. We got time for one more?
No, like you.
Got time for one more?
We get paid by the song, right?
Six songs.
Really? Is that how it works?
Let's do.
Cool.
This song is. Did anybody in here know exotic dancers? Anybody know an exotic dancer? Yeah? No, nobody in this room knows an exotic dancer. Look at this crowd. Nobody here knows.
Craven doesn't know it. Wait a minute. Let me try it this way. We got to work with the audience here. Wait a minute.
This song.
Anybody know a titty dancer?
There you go.
There you go. See?
Craven. Jesus.
Exotic dancer, like, huh?
I'm going to have to introduce you to guys. To some girls, I guess. All right. Anyways, this is about one in particular. Exotic dancer. It's called Deal With Yourself. You can lie and lie to yourself till you're blue in the face. Or you can lie to me and say that you're a master of grace. You can buy some time with a tit and your ass and your face. You can draw the line and tell me that you don't feel disgrace. If you ever have to deal with yourself, feel disgrace. You can lie to all of your friends and say you don't give a damn. You can fight some time with your tits and your ass and your face. You can go the line and tell me that you don't feel disgraced. We're not friends anymore. We got Zig-Zag in the house, right? Out there somewhere? Yeah? Where?
I think they left.
They left already? All right.
We were late.
Yeah, we were late.
It's your fault, by the way.
Yeah, it was my fault.
It was your fault.
Yeah.
I got your house. You're still in shorts. I mean, come on.
You guys want to do a sing-along? You know the theme from Gilligan? That's not it. It's this song. We're gonna teach. We're gonna teach you this song on the fly. Okay.
Yeah,
it's a real
song,
easy
yeah.
one. This song is about alcohol abuse. So.
Yeah, even Rebecca can sing this song. It's really easy.
Y'all.
Dina can sing this song.
Yeah.
It's as simple as that.
Almost anybody.
Yeah. Almost anybody.
I think Dina will sing along with us.
Yeah, look how she comes.
We're missing the Pistols tonight. We usually have two beautiful, sexy, sultry girls that sing with us.
Instead, you got me.
Yeah. We're more like Shotgun Junkies sawed off tonight is what we are.
Hey, speak for yourself, big boy, all right? You got that Alice Cooper look going?
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you all. We're Shotgun Junkies. We're debuting with the full band tomorrow night over in Seminole, Florida at the Amped Original Music Festival. All right, let's give it up for Amped.
Yeah, that's Anthony Arnold's not going to be there.
Hey, listen, I do want to say one other thing. A good friend of mine passed away 2 years ago this day.
That wasn't him. Yeah. Should have been, but it wasn't him.
Yeah. I'd like to just say a little bit of a memorial here really quickly to Matt Laporte. I love Matt Laporte. Matt, we love you, brother.
All right, well, there you go. Up there, Shotgun Junkies unplugged. Oh.
It's all off tonight.
It sounds good, though. I don't know. You guys should play some more music. I don't know.
It's a lot bigger with the whole band. But I know it is. It's fun this way.
That's all we know.
You could talk Rebecca Field into going up there and playing your guitar there, buddy.
I could, but I'm not.
I ain't saying nothing.
Rebecca, you want to play some guitar?
Yeah, she wants to.
She can't.
That's what we got. Rebecca.
We got a stage. We got lights. We got a microphone, a guitar. She's wondering up here. See that?
Yep.
She can't wait.
Plug
she's
back
just
in.
Wondering. She's like, come on.
Plug that box back in. Yeah. You know, Rebecca's always.
She likes her box plugged in.
She likes that box plugged in.
Yeah. Yeah.
The direct box.
Yeah, the guitar. Keep your mind clean, all right?
Yeah. Yeah, we're trying to keep it clean. Not. Rebecca Peeled on the acoustic guitar. She didn't like the other thing. We gave her a bus guitar, and she doesn't like that. So now she's going to actually play something, I think, maybe. Aren't you, honey? Say you love me. Get on the mic. Say you love me.
Hello.
Hi. Hey. How you doing? Don't get all blonded out. Just because you got blonde hair and a guitar doesn't make you a rock star.
Anybody like the blues in here? We're going to do a little improv blues right now. Thank you.
I'm okay, but that's not what gets
is the pain of losing you everywhere I go. But I'm doing it hard to force their smile when I see our old friends not alone. Still harder getting up, getting dressed, living with this regret. But I know I can do it. Try to take away all the tears that I saved in my heart.
Thank you so much.
What
I do? Well, isn't Jeff Vitolo in the house?
Rebecca.
For fuck's sake.
I need you, Reby.
Because you know when Jeff's in the house, it all shit stops. Okay?
I need my Rebinator.
It stops.
Jeff Vitolo in the house. He's in here.
He's cute, too.
Rebecca, I need you. Please come.
As soon as Betty quits knocking my teeth out of my face.
He walked out the back door. That's no excuse.
I'm old today, so I did not get to build a doll to resemble Rebecca Field or Dina Mead, but I did bring a wig, and I'm now Dina Mead.
Wait a minute. Not enough attitude in the voice.
I don't quite look like Dina yet.
You need more attitude in the voice.
Wait, I can change that. Here, hold on. I'll look like Dina Mead in a minute. I'm Dina Mead.
Wait a minute. You're bigger than she is.
Am I? I know. Well, you know, hey, what can I say? I've got to do a few more exercises.
Apparently.
Who the hell wrote this chicken scratch here?
I wrote it really quick.
I don't think you know what you're talking about. Thank you.
All right. I've been handed a note.
Rebecca's got her hand up some guy's butt. Oh, it's a puppet. Oh, I'm sorry.
That's nothing new. I'm Karnak.
Yep. It keeps. Stand a little more to your left. You're gonna hit your chin on the way down to the trapdoor.
Are we gonna do an interview here? Are we gonna get?
I'm trying to read. I am trying to read these questions that somebody.
Well, just make them up,
me.
Man. Don't worry about that.
All right. No, seriously though. All right, we'll get seriously. Buddy and Lee. Tell me about Shotgun Junkies. You know, who are you guys? You know, your newer band, you obviously just started out. You've played a few places so far, unplugged a couple places. You're actually making your electric debut, I know, tomorrow at Amped, which I'm looking extremely forward to. I know you got a couple surprises there and everything.
Yeah, we've got some show planned.
Tell me a little bit about the history.
Shotgun Junkies is a new band. It's only 2-3 months old, okay? But the truth of the matter is I've been doing these songs for a while. It is sort of Dina's fault. I've been doing these songs for quite a while around town in, you know, open jam type things. I'll go in and sing my songs, and I, you know, just grab musicians out of the stage, you know, off the floor. Dina wanted me to do the thing, and I said, all right, I'll put together my buddies. And it ended up being more than buddies. These are some of my best friends in the world.
Makes a difference.
Not really a new band in that aspect. I mean, all the band members have been in this area. I've been myself for many years. Lee Pons is a freaking local legend.
Absolutely.
John Spinelli is our drummer, and any of the drummers in the Tampa Bay area are familiar with John Spinelli, I would hope. He is absolutely a local legend. We have a guy named Bill Blackwell on guitar. We call him the Wizard. This guy is phenomenal. He's been he was in Gypsy Gangbang for 7 years, and he's been around.
And nobody seems to know what his
Gypsy
face
gang
looks
gang?
Like.
Yeah, he keeps his face covered. The guy wears a hood.
Real
the guy
mystery.
Wears a hood at all times. Yeah.
Gypsy Gangbang.
He's terribly.
Seriously?
Yeah.
Who was that?
California band.
Gypsy Gangbang. Yeah. All right, I got it. Bill
they were like a national. Google them, I believe. At any rate, and then I think the best part of the whole band, in my opinion, is the Pistols. We have two extremely sultry, sexy girls, Sunny Ray and Tammy Steed. Sunny Ray is actually, she's not here tonight because she actually works with Tommy Rocks and his Lynyrd Skynyrd tribute band, Nothing Fancy. They're doing a show in Kissimmee or something.
Who Tommy Rocks will also be at AMP tomorrow night with Big
absolutely.
Deal.
Yeah,
but
absolutely.
That's one of the big reasons deal. Why one
big
of the
deal.
Pistols weren't here tonight.
Tommy that's Rock, right. Rock. That's
well,
right.
You
and
know,
the
I
other Pistol
you,
had a gig.
You know,
so
the only reason I, out. The only reason we wanted you guys at AMP was, you know, because of them two. You know, I mean.
You're right, exactly.
We just wanted to stare at them.
Well, you know, Tammy was standing next to Lee last week, and I said, "My God, this is like Beauty and the Beast." And she said, "Don't ever call me Beast again." You know, so.
This is now my fucking radio show. The only reason why you guys actually are a part of a band is because of me. Because
it's not the only reason. Like we had to learn to play instruments before you asked us to be in a band. But however,
fuck you, you cockfuck.
Yeah, you can't say that on the air.
It's not FCC regulated, so.
Well, being that this is going out on FM,
yeah, it might be a good idea to go ahead and.
All right.
How dare you?
Oh, we have okay.
So anyway,
how dare you, Mr. Ponzi Pants?
There's no way I'm gaining control of this. There's no way.
So anyhow.
Tell me about your music. You know, your original music and everything. Yeah. How do you describe the style? What is your sound?
We call it high energy rock, high energy hard rock. What we're actually doing is we gear this music toward the ladies. Our slogan actually reads, "Rock hard and the ladies will come." Okay, we only, quite frankly, only care about ladies coming because there's an old adage in the business: if you can bring the ladies, you can bring the men. So you know we're gonna fill that place up with ladies and make the bar happy, and go on from there. You know, but the bottom line is, almost all the songs are danceable. To a certain extent, if you like to dance to rock, they are very danceable.
If you like to beat the shit out of somebody,
that's it.
You know.
And we like to give a big show. We're sort of trying to, like you said, there's a few surprises tomorrow. You know, we're shooting for that Kiss meets Meatloaf kind of show. You know, we're gonna keep them entertained. You know, at all times. So.
You know, I just got a vision in my head there. Kiss meets Meatloaf, and
it wasn't pretty, was it? Like Meatloaf with makeup on. God, thank God I lost that weight
to see that. Really, seriously. How did you guys? I mean, you know, you've like you've mentioned, you've got a pretty impressive lineup. You know, as far as local, musicians go and everything. How did you guys decide to get together?
I have been writing songs for a long time, and I've worked with all of these people over the years. We've done recordings.
Great, thanks a lot, buddy. Well, nice to meet you. Just kidding.
Thank you, Rebecca. We love you too, honey. Anyway, yeah, we worked over the years. We worked over the years together a lot. Me and John especially. We're actually in another recording project
Rebecca's
called Thorns of Glory, and
So
we're familiar with each other's style. You know, we've been doing this.
Rebecca,
for a long
what happened
time.
To your shirt?
Lee, I've played with over the years on and off. You know, Lee's been, like I say, a legend in the area. We've done a lot of jams together, and we've been friends for how long, Lee? What do you say, 20,
Wait,
30 years?
Wait, I got Rebecca and Dina on top of
too
me.
Long.
I can't breathe.
I got little Keith on my shoulder. So. Yeah.
But you know, it's all about this band is all about the music, writing. It's not the show is secondary to the music. You know,
right.
We really want to make that stuff tight. We want to make sure that these people come back because they like what they hear. You know, so this is just too distracting with the Keith doll on Keith.
You're
the
trying,
Keith
no, bro,
Keith doll on Keith.
I am trying
it's all good
so
fun.
Hard right now to keep this together. Did I not warn people that I had no
this,
idea?
This is much funner than the other thing I was going to do, which was stay home and rest.
I hate to say this, girl, but someone needs to go on a diet. Anyway.
It's probably the puppet.
Did we? Yeah.
Probably the puppet.
Yeah, how are we?
Oh, look, Jeff's here.
Hey, what's up? I need another beer.
Oh, we got 15 minutes.
So anyways, Keith, I'd just like to say to everybody out there that if you want to see a new band that will rock your ass, just come on out. Just come on out and see us. And right, and then you can hang out for Undercover Betty because they come on right after us and they rock.
You know,
yeah, but Rebecca,
you can't go wrong.
I just want to get that on tape, baby.
I just for the record, Betty King rocks his own world.
That's not what she said before I gave her the mic. However,
you know, see what happens when you get woman control.
You can't go wrong tomorrow, LaDamp. You can't go wrong tomorrow, LaDamp. You're gonna have the pistols. You're gonna have Undercover Betty. You're gonna see sexy women all the way around.
All day long, brother.
I mean, Dina Mead. You're gonna have Dina Mead there. Chances are, at least one person is gonna take their top off.
Oh, Dina's gonna be there.
Yeah.
Lord, I committed to this thing. I didn't know Dina was gonna be there.
Tomorrow has absolutely nothing to do with me.
I was gonna try to keep her locked up in the cage, but you know, she gets.
Craven's over here with this look on his face like, this is getting boring, guys. You need to pick this shit up, man.
All right. Now, we've discussed anything more. Have we discussed the pistols already? I mean, anything more?
Well, yeah, we did. We talked about Sonny Ray and Tammy Steed.
What about let's talk about tomorrow in Amped and everything, your performance in Amped. Now, I mean, I know I've seen that you've got a few surprises up your sleeve, and I honestly, I'm looking very forward to it, and I hope I'm going to be able to control the fact, since I'm emceeing the event, I hope I'll have a little bit more control over it.
I wouldn't count on that, brother.
Daddy, okay?
I think you need to bring some backup there, man.
I'm thinking of a shock collar for Dina. only problem is she'd enjoy it too much.
You know, we debuted on Reverb Nation, which is anybody that's not familiar with that, it's where original bands will put their music up on there, and you can download it, you can stream it for free, okay? And you can also buy it. So reverbnation.com/ Shotgun Junkies fan is where you can go listen to our music for free. We debuted 4 weeks ago at the 2016 spot here in Tampa, in the Tampa market, and we've risen to number 19. And we were shooting for the top 20 for this particular thing. And we have been down as low as 16, but we have lost a little bit of power. I think after tomorrow, maybe after tonight, it'll pick back up. So go listen to it. And every time you guys click on it, it raises our score and gets us closer to number one. And that's where it's at. It really is.
Great. Awesome. So tomorrow night... looking extremely forward to having you guys out at Amped, and I would like to give a shout out to Buddy. First of all, for those who don't know, the Amped logo is actually designed by Buddy King and his airbrushing company.
Yeah, and we Extreme Air Studios.
Yeah, Extreme. Yes, Airbrush Studios. Mm-hmm. And first of all, I do want to thank you for that.
Thank you.
You did a great job.
Thank you for letting me be involved.
Oh, absolutely! You did a great job on the logo. I love it. And you want to look, we got a banner of the logo right above the stage that you've been watching when you've been watching the bands perform. I'm looking extremely forward to having you guys out, as I am with all the other great bands we have on the lineup. And it always does me a great pleasure to be able to promote the local original music scene. And yes, Keith is still here, unless you're referring to Little Keith, which I flushed him down the toilet. I paid someone out there.
She's blonde hair. Looks like nice boobies, too, though.
Anyway, Lee.
Yes, Little Keith.
If I may, I don't know if I'm worthy enough to ask the great Lee any questions. If not,
no, but go ahead. What the hell?
Anyway, is there anything Lee would like to add to this total debauchery going on right now?
I added too much of the debacle as it going on as it was. What is this?
I'm sorry. Was Lee talking? What the hell was that?
Is Keith still here?
He speaks New Orleans, man. You can't understand that man
at
all.
What are you trying to say?
I don't know what the fuck you want
right.
to say.
You want me to read the schedule? Is that you trying to tell me, Dina? Dina shoved this paper in my...
I asked you for something, and I don't know if
You should be lucky. I've seen Dina shove a lot worse things in front of men's faces than that.
Yeah. Well, you know. But you know what? I do want to do a shout-out real quick. That's
R.I.P. to a buddy of mine, Doc Randy, who just passed away on a couple days ago. And right live on the fast, you know, had a brain hemorrhage live on stage, and dropped there right after. So he finished the song though. Got him down, and he held out for a couple of days. I knew the motherfucker could keep a beat, but I just didn't realize he was that good at it. But no, a little shout out to my buddy Randy and stuff. We're gonna miss you, and God bless you. We'll see you up in the road gig up in the sky one day, just not today. But anyway, anything else I can add? Not really. No, I'm gonna blast with the Shotgun Junkies, man. It's like I haven't played bass in a long time. And I've been playing mostly piano and doing all the blues stuff and doing real well with that.
But actually, from...
I know, you played the organ, I know.
It came back to me as, God damn it, Dina fucking stuck me with this fucking bullshit.
Basically, yeah, that's true.
And, I would like to add, Lee, too, for all those listening right now, if you haven't checked out this Lee's video he did for Juke Joints, Ladies, and Whiskey... you got to check that out the video. Obviously, you can check it out. Probably look it up at YouTube. And
it's on the Reverb Nation page, yeah. And YouTube is the easiest place to find it.
It's a cute little video that he's got for Juke Joints, Ladies, and Whiskey. I laughed my ass off. I don't remember what I was drinking at the time, but I think I about.
And then we got the other one.
I spit it out all over my computer.
What was the other one? When I Go Out at Night? Have you seen that one yet?
I haven't actually seen that one.
Oh, you guys seen that one. If you liked the first one, you guys need to do one. That one's all like. If you're a Star Trek fan, trust me, you'll love this thing. It's hilarious.
Yeah, I heard about that. It's actually you were on your show on Rock Slam.
Yeah.
You had Charlie Souza.
Right.
A friend of mine
out
there. And, no, Charlie is not
good.
Here.
I
believe
don't like
he
that. He owes me money. But no.
No, Charlie actually has a show tonight. He's actually performing at the Star Spectacular.
He's getting paid?
I think so. I don't know what they're
lucky
paying
bastard.
Him in. You know, but no, he does have a show tonight. I wish I could be there to see him. But
I do too.
You know,
I'm just saying that
because
there's a mic on there. That's it.
anyway, you know, I would like to take a moment. Actually, I was going to save this for later, but since you did bring up the point up about, of course, Doc's unfortunate passing away.
Yeah, Doc Randy. God bless him.
And, you know, I would like to take this opportunity, too. Buddy had touched base on it earlier. And for the readers of my column, I'm sure they've read my, hopefully they read my article. Is there still people reading my column? No, I didn't.
At least
so.
One.
I didn't know you had one.
I read it too. You're my fan.
I think you said my name in it, so I had to read it.
You write an article?
Yeah. Hi, I'm Keith Wilkins.
Oh, you're him.
I'm him.
Oh, dude, I thought you were like.
It's not the doll.
I thought the doll
doesn't write.
I thought you were Jeff Vitolo. Oh, Jesus Christ!
All this time I thought you were shorter.
I was going to say he looks taller on stage.
I walked in and saw the puppet, and I actually I was like, oh my God, Keith, man, he's on his knees or something.
I thought you were Craven Morehead. I thought you were like getting less head.
Well, let's put it this way: the little Keith doll that was here earlier, it got more action in the past like 3 hours than I've gotten in the past 3 months. So. No, but seriously, take it down a little bit. I do want to touch base too. If the readers who read my column today, I did an article on it, and many don't remember. Today does actually mark a date in our local history as being 420. That it was 2 years ago today that Matt LaPorte was found passed away in his home in Seminole.
Yeah. He's a good friend of mine too, man.
And you know, and I think, you know, outside of the fact, I mean, obviously, you know, the talent aspect. You know, he's a fairly talented guitarist. But I think for those who knew Matt LaPorte personally too, the one thing that they know about Matt was his sense of humor. The guy had a sense of humor, and I'd actually, you know, I want to share just one a short story just about that happened with me and Matt one time. No, it's well, you know, I'm the one telling it, so probably it will take longer than it should be. You know, I'd kick back, get some popcorn. When I tell a story, a 5 minute story will take me 5 hours.
No, let's talk about Matt LaPorte first.
No.
Let's talk about Matt.
Obviously, but. You know, one incident. I first met Matt about 13 years ago. At the time, he was playing with Kingpin, local cover band. And me and some friends of mine would always go out and see Kingpin perform all the time when they'd go out. And a perfect example of Matt LaPorte's sense of humor is, at the time, both me and Matt drank the same type of drink. We both liked Smirnoff Ices. And one time, we're out at Gators. Kingpin's playing at Gators. And I'm sitting here. I got a Smirnoff Ice, of course, and we got our drinks set up right at the table, right next to the side of the stage at Gators. And there's, you know, a couple of us, me and another friend, a couple of girls are with us, and we're out there, you know, dancing during the songs and everything and this and that. And I keep going back to my drink, and I'm drinking. Now, for those who know me personally, I am a slow drinker. I'm not a big drinker. So it takes me a while just to get through one beer, you know. I'm a leisure, you know, what can I say, you know? You know, I'm sitting there, but, you know, finally after a while, I'm realizing it's taken me forever to get through this one beer. I haven't had to go up and buy a new beer. It's like, it's taken me forever. And, you know, but it's one of those things I'm just not noticing. I'm having fun. I'm dancing. Kingpin's rocking. Matt LaPorte's doing his thing, as always. And at one point, finally, about like a halfway through the night, I leave to go out to use the restroom. I come back, and what do I see? I come back walking in, you know, gotcha. For those been to Gators, there goes Tokyo. You know, Gators has a bathroom outside, so, you know, I'm coming back in, and what do I see? But Matt LaPorte's up there. He's up on stage. He's got my drink in one hand, and he's got his drink, and he's pouring his into mine, and he was doing that the whole night. So I'm sitting here taking forever. I'm like sitting here not thinking. I'm getting fucked up. You know, I'm getting screwed up, and I'm flying high now. But you know, it's like one beer. I'm like, what's going on? The guy was up there all night long, and he's telling everybody, shut up. And he's pouring his drink into mine just a little by little, to where I wouldn't even notice. You know, but I caught him that time. But you know, the point being, all seriousness aside, is that's an example of Matt LaPorte's subtle. Oh, yeah. Sense of humor he had, you know, and you know,
that was a great guy, man.
Great story. Yeah, great,
that was
dude.
A great story. Yeah. Is it over? Thank God.
And I wish somebody filled my drink.
I thought it was going to get little funny at some point, too. Keith.
But what a great guy he was, man.
Anyway,
look, hey,
you know, I was talking.
A lot of people, you know him as a musician and playing. I remember him like at my house with less talent coming over, hanging out. You know, love those guys, and just. Being able to hang with a guy like that, just he's just a regular dude like us, you know, he's a regular dude.
Absolutely.
And he's truly missed, man.
I was
so is Les Talent.
I was out at Gators last night to see the new Kingpin because my drummer Spinelli is actually in Kingpin,
right?
As he was at that time. And they've reformed that band with Matt Buckner and Justin
and
Lee Walker.
Sound
and, oh, it's phenomenal.
They
it's phenomenal. Great. Donnie O'Neill, oh my God, man. I mean, what a set
and
of pipes on that.
I've known Spinelli since the 1900s, too.
Oh,
man.
Yeah. We grew up together. All these guys. Hey, Jeff, we were just talking about it. We're all old and we've all lived here a long time. Anyway, oh, except Rebecca. Yeah. She's going backwards from like 20. She had like her 21st birthday, and now she's down to about 16 or something.
I remember
Rebecca.
She's
looking cute, man.
Yeah, she's jailbait now.
But I'd like to just say this.
I remember her with another fake ID playing at the volley club.
Another local guy that all of us know.
I didn't even hug your neck tonight. I'm so sorry. I should have, but I didn't.
The night ain't over yet.
I ran into another local guy that we all know. We all have known for years and years and years, and he shot to the top here recently. Last night, I went out with Todd LaTorre. We went up to see Kingpin. Actually, I met him up there, and we had the Matt discussion, you know. And Todd, you know, Matt introduced Todd to the guys in Crimson Glory, you know.
Yeah.
And if it weren't for Matt, and I'm sure that Todd will be the first one to say this, he would not be the singer for Queensryche today.
Sure.
I'm sure of it. He is sure of it. He would not have a Wikipedia page. Okay, anyone that doesn't know who Todd LaTorre is, get on your Google and type Todd LA. That's all you have to do.
Yeah.
Okay.
Are you kidding me? People more know Todd than you know us.
I remember not too
who
long
are
ago,
you again?
Yeah, I remember not too long ago we were talking to him about. I said one of these days you're going to get a Wikipedia page. He says, "Yeah, that'll be the day." And a year later, he has one. Yeah. I mean, it's not. He doesn't just have one. I mean, he's blowing up. That boy's on fire.
Does any of us here have a
For
Wikipedia
those of the,
page?
The people
yet?
Don't know how great of a drummer Todd LaTorre is too. Todd was always a drummer, a singer too, but right. Nobody knew his vocal capabilities. I mean, I've known him since he was a kid. He used to say, "I look up to you so much," and I'm thinking. Damn.
Look, it's because he's only 3'9", but that's regardless.
And I felt like saying, well, that's my dress, but...
I went to school with him. He's short.
He is an incredible, incredible talent, and good for him. Good for him. I'm so happy for him. Also a beautiful soul. So that all works together, and he deserves everything that he's gotten.
The truth of the matter is, Todd has not changed at all. Todd is Todd. He's not going to change. I don't care how big he gets. He will not change. He will always be Todd. You know, and yeah.
In the band back in the day, when Infrared, back with Mac Buckner and Todd and Jerry. Yeah. And stuff.
I remember that.
Well, yeah, back. That's how I remember Rebecca. And my life went downhill ever since. But, but no,
you don't know me.
I used to spend a lot of time in Rebecca's music store. Right.
Well,
I think you got quite a bit of money off of me, didn't you?
Yeah, there's a million listeners right now. Thank you.
I ripped you off.
This mic is not working.
Oh, now you tell me. 15 years later.
Is this thing on?
There we go. I'm here all night, man. Take your time. I'm here all
good.
Night.
Good.
Oh, okay. Let's.
So I was sitting here talking. The mic wasn't even on. Boy, you guys missed some good stuff. I would say.
Let me just fill my beer back up. All right. Matt's in the house.
Hey, waitress, can I get a beer, please?
Yeah.
Be like that. What is that? Saturday Night Live. Talk amongst yourselves. I give you a topic.
Talk amongst yourselves. Well,
as far as Matt goes, man. Rest in peace, brother. We love you, man. You're with us every day.
Yeah, absolutely.
A minute that goes by that we don't. Every time I hear a song that I've seen Matt play, it just pops into my head. You know, I mean, I think about all kinds of. Just a couple weeks before he died, we went to Chick-fil-A, and he had his little salad, because you know how he was. And I got him to eat a piece of chicken. I snuck a piece of chicken onto it. Yeah, he got pissed off, and you know. but we ended that day all telling each other. You know, we loved each other, and that was good because I 2 weeks later he was gone, and felt good.
What we want to do is we want to get back to the music.
Let's get back to the music. And man, could he play though? Man, could he play?
Oh my God!
We're gonna go to some music.
We're gonna go out there and do some music,
and we'll come back with Jeff Vitolo.
And we're gonna do Jeff Vitolo on stage, right?
Sure. Absolutely.
Well, I thought we were gonna do a little interview in here. Yeah, I got my girl.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
We'll do that as well.
Yeah.
We'll do that as well.
Let's well, what you guys we'll do that now?
Play the new song. Boom, boom, pow.
Yeah, why don't you guys do that now while me and Buddy get set up and that kind of stuff?
Well, your interview's not done, man. I still got to learn more about you guys.
Oh, well, I can tell you about the time in band camp.
How much to know?
One time in band camp.
I think Craven's itching to play some music right now, so.
Let the man DJ.
Yeah.
Well, let's put a Magic Mike CD on. We got to drive some people out of here.
I'm going to give this mic to Rebecca.
Don't do
and
that.
Say, please,
don't,
just don't, everyone don't go, do check out Shotgun Junkies. We have four songs. We have our EP. So please go to Reverb Nation, Shotgun Junkies fan. It's reverbnation.com/Shotgun Junkies fan. And hopefully we can talk Craven into throwing a link on his page. He says, he gave us a thumbs up there. So, yeah. All right, man. So, go listen to it and come out and see us all tomorrow.
Absolutely.
I'm so excited to play with Rebecca and all these people.
Over there at the Pope's Pub.
Diamond Gray. The lineup is unbelievable.
Yeah, it's a
Zig-Zag USA. You got Diamond Gray.
Hey, John still over there running sound?
You know, this is the kind of thing.
John Tech's
still
over there.
Running sound.
Shout out, John Tech.
Does he coming out there?
Does an awesome job. John Tech.
Boomers.
Huh?
Remember he was at
Boomers.
Way back
remember,
in the day.
Are you coming out tomorrow, Jeff?
I got a prior commitment at the strip club.
He's lying.
I got a DJ tomorrow.
Saying, that's his way of saying no.
Well, I'm gonna get out of this booth, but
I got to pay my bills, man.
You couldn't pay me to be there.
I took off tonight to be here, though, just for the record.
Just to see us.
I could have been DJing at a strip club with a feature dancer, making tons of cash. What are we doing but I'm here? Back in my hometown of North Tampa just to drink some beer and hang out with some friends. That sound good?
I tell
you. You know, it's like that is gotta be the dumbest thing I've ever heard in my life.
That's all right, because I'll be back.
But I love you for
I'll
that.
I'll be back at the strip club tomorrow night, DJ. It'll be there tomorrow.
I'm gonna hand over this mic, but I'd like to just do a quick shout out if I can to
absolutely.
One of the pistols is my girl, Sunny Ray, okay?
Sunny.
Everybody loves Sunny Ray, and she's an adorable little redhead.
Yeah, did you snag a beautiful woman?
I have no idea. I lied my ass off, I think. I don't know. I put on a mask and lied like a son of a bitch. She should have seen the first time I pulled that mask off, man.
It's because he promotes himself like his band.
Yeah.
There you go.
Frame me up a Facebook like Reverb Nation, and I'll take you out on a date.
I can tell you how I met her.
Blackmails him.
pedophiles,
her band
actually
played in front
I'll
of my
tell
band,
you, Mom.
And that's how I met her. So, but at any rate, I just want to say a shout out to her. I want to say a quick shout out to her and Tommy Rocks, because I'm pretty sure they're listening right now online. They just finished her show.
Tommy Rocks, what's up?
I have to add that we feel really, I feel terrible that we have not played all of these original CDs tonight, because all of us have big mouths and we kind of took up all the time that we were going to play these original CDs, Tommy Rocks, Diamond Gray. So the fact that we missed out on that, we apologize to all you guys that are listening and to hear your music. But please come out and see the show. I mean, all the bands that are playing tomorrow, it's very important you come out and support the original music. Thank you, Radio Bar and Grill. Thank you, Craven Morehead, for supporting the original material and allowing and providing us a venue and an outlet to do this. We thank you so much.
And definitely keep
listening. And that comes from a girl with a puppy.
We'll see you all out there tomorrow.
And keep listening to WPRN in 102.1 FM, because although we didn't get a chance to play a lot of them tonight, they do play these songs on the air on a regular basis. I know I hear them. I know Hoff
evidently
from Hanging on the Hoff plays Diamond Gray several times. I've heard him play Diamond Gray stuff, and you'll definitely be able to hear it.
Well, next on the set list, we have what? The Mexican mariachi music?
Yes, Mexican mariachi.
The International Hour?
Yes. And then we're moving into some. Yeah.
I thought I loved you, but I shot you instead.
No, I think I loved you, but I shot you instead. That's a good song.
I know I told you, but I loved you, but not enough to ruin my life.
There you go. All right.
Who's this dude?
So I'm gonna turn it back over here, and then what we're gonna do is I'm gonna talk to
my band's showing up in here now.
I'm gonna talk to Jeff Vitolo here for a second, and then I'm gonna change microphones. Whatever. And what we're gonna do is I think we're gonna play one of your songs, and you're actually gonna go on live for a minute, right?
Oh no, we're not playing on live.
I thought you were.
No,
not tonight.
That's why I brought all that music you can play.
Oh man!
But look what I brought with me. I brought my two backup
all
singers.
Right, let him
my harmonica
pass
player.
The mic around. You guys know what to do with that.
You know, I got Yana, I got Jessica, and my harmonica player.
Hey guys,
Lindsay
how
Mercer.
Are you?
And all four of these,
Thank
people.
Good evening, everyone.
They were all in the Dive Bar Stalkers with me too. You know, me and Lindsay, we did a couple records
Another
together.
Great
we did a couple records together.
That's great.
And it's all on there.
So tell us what it's all about, because I've got Buddy back up on stage. I think he's going to do a song or two, right?
Well, let's do that.
And then what we're going to do, and then we're gonna get up on stage and take care of. Is that all yours?
Yes, Bob.
Everybody.
Thank you, Craig.
It's not a problem, Early.
Craig,
all right, so.
No problem, Lee. We'll hold up the radio show, man.
So, y'all introduce yourselves, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna let Buddy play a song, and then I'm gonna play your song, and then we're gonna talk about what the heck's what's up with the Quarter Mile Rebels, you know, that kind of thing, you know.
Having a good time, man. Rock and roll.
That's what rock and roll is all about. So we're gonna keep you on the air and keep it happening.
Okay.
You know, here at the Party Pirate, and that's what we do.
Let Buddy do his thing.
Let Buddy sing that song. Let's get a beer and a smoke and make it happen. And then we're going to put you back, you guys, right back. As a matter of fact, we're going to do it on stage, I think, right?
We're getting Lee set up.
We're going to do the interview on stage on camera.
Oh, you do the interview on stage as well?
Maybe.
Let's do the interview right here, man.
Yeah, why don't we do the interview here? We'll take a break, and then we'll do the what we need to do up there on stage.
Oh, kiddie, okay. We'll take care of that.
There we go.
All right, so stay tuned. This is the Radio Bar and Grill. I'm going to put, where's Buddy? Up. He's back there. He's got his guitar. He's ready to rock. So here we go. We're going to get back to the live music here.
Buddy.
At the Radio Bar and Grill. Stay tuned.
No need to see, was only having fun. Shed a messed up head. You know she's a young gun. She's so young. She likes to use it. She's so young. You know she's a bold one. She's so young. She likes to use it. She's so young, she likes to use it. She's so young. You know she's a bold one. She's so young. She likes you. She's so young. You know she's a bold one. She's so young. She likes you. She's so young. Bang! Bang! Bang!
Well, that was the end of the song there, ladies and gentlemen. Should we have went bang again?
Go ahead, make noise. You're not going to wake the baby up. You got it now?
Wake up. Look around. Can you see what's happening in your town? Can you hear? Can you hear what I'm saying? That's okay, cause we're gonna waste the oxygen anyway. Skin is master. We have lost this race. Our morals are crumbling right in our face. Good old days. Didn't have a clue. They roll over in the grave and they caught a glimpse of you. Sin is master. We've lost his race. Our morals are crumbling right in our face.
As the guitar dies again. All right. Well, that was pretty cool, Lee, considering the fact Lee's never heard that song, guys. Give it up for Lee Pons, man, on the fly, right? All right, listen, what's going on next? We got Jeff coming up here or not? Or is Jeff just in the house for an interview?
We can't miss
Come
him.
Come on, Jeff.
What's that big tall guy with the mutton chops?
Come on.
There he is. Come over here, Jeff. You'll find out when you get here.
You don't mind if I do a Lady Gaga song, do you? It's been a long time since I came around. It's been a long time, but I'm back in town. And this time, I'm not leaving without you. Tastes like whiskey when you kiss me all. I'll give anything, you'll be my baby doll. And this time, I'm not leaving without you. Well, sit back down where you belong, in the corner of my bar with your high heels on. Sit back down on the couch where we made love for the first time. You said to me, there's something about this place. It's a cool place you got here. something about lonely nights and your lipstick on my feet. Something about my cool rock and roll gal. Yeah, something about you and I. It's been 2 years since I let you go. I couldn't listen to a joke or rock and roll. And muscle cars drove a truck right through my heart. On my birthday, you played me a heart of gold with a guitar strumming and you had no clothes. And this time, I'm not leaving without you. I ain't going nowhere, man. Well, sit back down where you belong, in the corner of my bar with your high heels on. Well, sit back down on the couch where we made love for the first time. You said to me, there's something about this place. Something about lonely nights and your lipstick on my face. Something about my cool rock and roll gal. Yeah, something about you and I. You and I. You and I.
I think we blew a fuse, man. With some, they pulled the plug on me.
What happened to your guitar?
I don't know what happened. The battery ran out. I think the battery ran out.
That might be.
Oh, well.
I don't know what's going on. All right, that's Jeff Vitolo right there. Come on, everybody. Put your hands together for him. Come on.
We tried it. Hey, thank you.
All right, Jeff, I think they want you back in the control room right now. Okay, gather your troop and get your butt in there. Thanks, everybody. We'll see you guys tomorrow night. There. All right, hang out. Jeff's going to be doing some stuff here. Hold on.
All right, crap. There you go.
Yeah, the battery now, died in that last song or something.
Yeah, well, it wasn't in here. We were trying to say that. I'm doing the best I can here with what I got to work with. Awesome. All right.
I didn't even know I was going to play. I didn't even know that song.
Go ahead, Keith, Kevin, whatever the hell your name is.
Should we bring the little Keith doll back in here for you again?
Bring little Keith back. You know, we need little Keith back.
He's got better personality than me anyway.
Right on.
Anyway, obviously here we have Jeff Vitolo, and who you just heard go up there and do a little impromptu, along with a couple of the members of the Jeff Vitolo and the Quarter Mile Rebels. And first of all, obviously, I want to thank you guys for joining us.
Hey, it's a great place, man.
I'm glad we finally got to get here. Oh, absolutely. I'd like to start out before we get into the Quarter Mile Rebels and introducing everybody first. Is Jeff, obviously, you've been around the scene for quite some time.
Woo!
I believe you came down here, if I'm not mistaken, in 85, was it? Started playing here?
First band, 85. Came here, 84.
84, okay.
Okay, put a band together called Entice. Had a band house about four blocks down the road. Used to tear this town up big time. That lasted till about Nirvana played Smelled Like Teen Spirit on the radio. And then
yep.
Then I went on and played in Tiger for like 3.5 years. And a couple bands, a band called Headshock. And then I joined Rock's Gang for a while. And then I formed into the Mojo Gurus. Did that for a while. Then I had a band for the past 6 years called the Dive Bar Stalkers. And now here we are today with the Quarter Mile Rebels, 13 albums later.
Yeah, I tell you. And,
and a little
know.
Less hair.
Yeah, don't we all have a little
couple
less
more
hair.
Wrinkles. A few bags under my eyes.
Yeah, and that's one of the things, you know, I'm very familiar with Entice. I remember then that was around the time when I actually came down to the in this area myself too.
So you remember the Sunset Club?
Yes, I remember the Sunset Club. Didn't get to go there, unfortunately. I am a tad younger.
Well, didn't stop anybody else from getting in there underage.
But
ask Gypsy. I remember that Sunset Club
works a little bit better
ID.
For the females 17. Than it does the males, though, to get into places where you're not allowed to. Anyway, yeah, I remember Entice, definitely. You guys did a good job. Very popular around this area, absolutely.
Had a great time.
And anyway, but now, of course, like you said, up until recently, you had the Dive Bar Stalkers, which I was a huge, huge fan of myself.
Thank you.
Thank you.
You know, and the main reason
and
for
these,
that.
These four, these three other people here were in the Stalkers,
yes,
too,
and,
for 6 years.
Actually, let's go ahead and right now, please introduce everyone here.
Well,
for us.
First of all, let me go over way to the far. This guy over here.
Hello, Lindsay everyone.
Mercer. Lindsay Mercer, our harmonica player. He's with
Cheers.
Me also from the Dive Bar Stalkers, the Florida State harmonica champion, and world renowned kite surfer.
That's right. I try and be very diverse.
We did two albums together, and we're working on new stuff right now, and you know, just keeping it going.
Yep.
And awesome. What did we do last night? Oh yeah, last night we played to a sold out show at the State Theater, opening up for Dick Dale and the Deltones. That was awesome. And this is our second national act with this band. We opened up for Southside Johnny and the Asbury Jukes over at the Capitol Theater just recently too. So we just proved to ourselves and everybody else that we can rock with the big dogs, with rock and roll legends. And I'll tell you what,
Dick
last
Dale,
night,
yeah.
Dick Dale,
brought the house down
75
last
years
night.
Old, that dude came out and just, I went home and had to go home and practice afterwards, bro. That's how good he was.
Yeah, we had a good time.
It was awesome.
Good show.
So we're coming off a big high. You're only as good as your last show if you're a musician. Remember
sure.
that. So I'm cool for a couple more days.
And who are these lovely ladies?
Now, these two girls right here, they're also in the Dive Bar Stalkers together. Okay, we got Yana and Jessica.
Hey, guys.
And we call them the Rebelettes. Yana's my wife. Okay. I got my wife in the band. This way, when I go on the road, I don't get in trouble.
It doesn't work out like that. But anyway, go ahead.
You'll still get in trouble.
I get more in trouble.
See, there you go. That's why I bring her with me.
Probably.
And, you know, they both these girls... Yana's did two records with me. She's been in, with me playing live, playing in the bands with me for about 6-7 years now. And Jessica joined the Dive Bar Stalkers, about 2 years? You were in there for 2 years.
Yeah.
She did her last record that we did called Full Speed No Brakes. And I brought them with me, and we got Talon Black plays drums in the Quarter Mile Rebels, and a guy named Michael Leslie plays bass in the Quarter Mile Rebels.
So can you guys do at least an acoustic version?
No, we can't. But we can come back in June and do a full show for you.
Schedule?
Absolutely.
Awesome.
I don't have a drummer or a bass player.
Well, right now.
Yeah, but I got that. I got.
But
the,
we're gonna play our new single, right?
I'm gonna play the new single.
Absolutely.
And then we're gonna. Well, I'm gonna play this new single, and then we're gonna set up for something else back on the stage, and then we'll be all good.
And I gave him I put out an album in January called Jeff Vitolo, The Best of the Dive Bar Days. I gave that to him also. If you ever want to play that,
so you're gonna be hearing that on the radio station
cool.
here at WPRN,
and
we're gonna we're gonna make it happen.
But the new single.
Vaginal.
The new single, I got it loaded up right now. If you guys want to hear it.
Tell us a little something about it first.
Well, this it's just pretty much the same stuff I've been doing with the Stalkers. It's kind of like a, you know, high-octane rockabilly blues rock and roll revival type thing, having a good time. This is a little bit more aggressive, a little more louder, a little more, you know, whatever. And it's just, you know, keep on moving, keep on grooving. That's what everybody's just trying to do every day in this life. Crank it up, play it loud, and whatever you got to do, man.
Absolutely.
That's what we do here, guarantee that.
And hopefully everybody in the Radio Bar and Grill will appreciate it, too, tonight. So, hey, I'll tell you what, man. It's my first time in here. This is a cool place
here.
Yeah, I love it. Absolutely, it is. Yeah.
I could see this as a reality show one day on TV.
It already is.
That would
you
be
don't
fun.
Believe it, you know, go play back some of our videos.
I just witnessed it. I witnessed it a little while ago. It was, like, really cool. I'm like,
yeah,
I'm glad I got out of bed for this.
Down in here.
Well, me and Craven. And
including toe-sucking.
Yeah.
I don't know. Yeah.
The stars of the show.
Toe-sucking.
It's awesome.
But anyway, so that's really great. All right, Jeff. So what we're going to do now is I guess we're going to play your single here from your thing, and then we're going to reset up and do whatever
sure.
we're doing to, you know, get more music or more live music, whatever you're doing. Any other questions you got for him?
Well,
your name,
we
Kevin?
Can.
Oh,
we can you need to find that dial. They keep forgetting who I am.
Little Keith.
No.
I think he left.
I got a few. Why don't we go ahead and play the song here, and we'll come back to Jeff and the rest of the band and everything, and we'll do a few more questions and everything, and maybe play another
fine.
Song if we can.
And I do
that's
got
fine.
Some people listening. They've been emailing me all day from all over the place because I've been promoting it. So everybody, I appreciate you tuning in tonight.
No, you never.
Crank
did.
This thing up.
Yay!
Do what you got to do, and remember, it is 4:20. So make
that's
sure you're
right.
4:20 when you're listening to this
it
thing
is
right
420.
Here.
4:20. It is 420, so here you go, ladies and gentlemen. Now, for the first time, you're going to hear it anywhere, probably. It's Jeff Vitolo and the Quarter Mile Rebels, and we're going to crank this thing up for you, I think. Awesome. There we go. We got it for you. Stay tuned to Party Fire 102.1.
Working every day for a little pay. Yeah, I'm drinking cheap beer cause I can't afford whiskey. Well, I'm used to walking cause I got no gas money. And I'm busting my ass just to see my honey. Down on a 57 Chevy. Yeah, I'm cruising all night right next to my baby. Yeah, we're going real fast, I bet you can't catch me. Ride with me, I'll play the radio loud. Come on, baby, let me take it downtown. I'll show you what I do when the sun goes down. Keep on moving, keep on moving. I'll take you to the roadhouse and pay your cover. Show you how I do it.
Keep on moving, keep on moving.
Now that's it.
All right.
Keep on moving. Keep on grooving.
Yeah. I tell you, you know, I think that's one of the things I love about your music, whether it's with the Quarter Mile Rebels or when you were in the Dive Bar Stalkers, you know, it's always upbeat. It's always, you know, like you said, happy music. And first of all, I love it because, you know, anybody that knows me, you know, I'm a lover of all musics. You go to my collection or something, my library, and I have everything from blues to country to rockabilly to you name it, I've got it. And
your STD closet too.
Yeah, it says that on my card. It wants me. I have to show that before to prospective girlfriends. Yeah, you name it, I got it. No. And the thing I love about it is the fact that you do the, you know, the rockabilly style sound and everything, in which I've always loved myself, because I think it's just to a certain extent shows a lot more of your talent as a musician. If you can do rockabilly and do it great, you know, it just shows emphasizes your talent even more. And it's one of those things where that kind of style of music nowadays, it's not really in the mainstream, as far as there's not a lot of people doing it.
Right.
You know, to where you can do it and still do it in a modern style. I mean, of course, there's everybody, you know, everybody knows the most famous one for doing it more in a modern style nowadays, of course, Brian Seltzer.
Yeah, it's great,
you know,
cast
and everything. Great guy, sounds amazing. But it's one of the things I love, you know, about you and the things you've been doing recently with your with the bands. Thanks. is you're carrying that on.
And not trying to be a purist, great, in any way, you know, just bringing that element,
yeah,
you know, and cranking it up, pouring a little gasoline on it.
Absolutely, know? And you're doing a great job of that. I really must say. Obviously, this is one of your newest songs, and when can we see a brand new, actually, it'd be your debut CD for this band?
Well, these days, a lot of people aren't even, they're putting out singles and doing EPs and stuff like that, so all we're going to do right now is just, okay, like, you know, this band's only been together really since, like, November, you know, since,
right,
we put it together, and we recorded that song, wrote it real fast, and recorded it real fast, so we're going to go in the studio, record another song, and we'll probably just record songs and release them as singles for a while, and then maybe by the end of the year we'll put it out as an album.
Okay.
The way everybody's doing it these days with iTunes and stuff, it's like you record a whole album and a lot of it gets lost, you know, and everybody's just downloading singles these days.
Absolutely, and you know, I'm glad you brought that
up. But I'm an album guy. I like the whole vibe of the album from the beginning to the end and stuff like that. But
I'm the same way. I cannot. I tell you right now, I do not own an iPod. I do not. That's not how I still. I'm old fashioned.
That's
I
good.
Like buying CDs. I like putting it in my car or my stereo at home. I don't walk around with an iPod.
The last one.
Yeah, you're the last guy.
I'm the last one spending
my car.
You know, I just. I'm just not that way, but I'm glad you said that, you know, because, you know, there is a lot of changes, and to a certain extent, whether you're talking the national level or the local scene,
yeah,
it's almost like we're still in the learning phase on how to market in the music industry right now.
It's all changed.
Whether you're in a band, whether you're a record label, whether you're, so much has changed that it's almost like trying to figure out, okay, what exactly is the formula now, you know?
It's and look, here's the deal, man. In 1989, I put out my first album with a deal. People were actually buying records. Luckily, I was with bands over, you know, through the 90s and stuff. Before the internet came out, I was able to sell records with bands. And there was actually times where you can actually, you know, sell CDs at your show. You know, sell CDs, get distribution deals, get kind of deals. But these days, with all the stuff on the internet for free, a lot of people are just giving their stuff away just so people can pay attention to them and everything. It's just, it's a whole different ball game. You know, back in the day, people used to buy, you know, like, when's the last time you went to a record store, hang out with your friends to wait for your favorite album to come out?
Do they even still have record stores
around? But just think how cool that was when you were a kid, you know, meeting your buddies at the record store.
That's about when they were on vinyl, too, you know. Yeah. It was really, like, it was cool in the day.
Yeah, you know. Now it's all on the internet. Now everything's so quick and so quick.
I found a whole case of my old jukebox records back when I was a kid. It was really pretty cool. Yeah. You know, you never know. They're 45s. You know?
Yeah.
You ever seen that?
Oh, yeah.
Craven, they even had 45s back when you were a kid?
Yeah. Shit. I'm not talking about the pistol. I'm talking
my
about
old lady.
I'm way past the 78 stage. Yeah. I'm not that goddamn old.
Awesome.
But those were the days when people used to really, you know, I like as a Kiss fan, as a kid, I can remember, you know, going to the Kmart or the record store the day Kiss Destroyer comes out because I wanted to buy it. These days, you know, you wait for stuff to come, you know, you get your little beep on your phone and something's out and you listen to it and you steal it off the internet. But it's not going to stop me from making music. Just not a lot of people buying it these days. You got to bring your music to the people and play live. That's pretty much what it's going down to.
It's definitely a challenge, that's for sure. And actually, and you being especially, you being around the scene here for, you know, quite a while and had performing, I'm sure, you know, you remember just like I do and many of our listeners do who have been in this area for a long time, how much the music scene, say in the 80s, how it was, it, you know, it was quite the hotbed here.
Because, yeah, well, they had a lot of other things that to do, you know, it is what it is these days, you know. Today's market
so
is about a live DJ, and it's so tough for a band to survive, and, you know, just to put gas in a truck to get to the next town, it's going to cost you a lot of money.
Absolutely.
And for the club owners and the venue owners, it's cheaper for them to get some young band to play for free. Which I don't blame them, because I did that when I was a kid too, you know. But it's changed, you know. It's around here, used to be more camaraderie with the radio stations and the clubs, and clubs were spending money at the radio stations, which meant
that was when Boomers was around, the Rock Club.
Absolutely,
that's the good old days.
It takes money. And a lot of people aren't putting money into it these days, you know?
No, there's not, because what you do is you take $5,000 worth of gear, load it into a $100 car, spend $25 on fuel to make $50 at the club you play in. That's where it is.
Right. As a musician, you don't really get paid to play. You just get paid to set your gear up and tear it down, you know? Enough for that.
It's not the same as it used to be.
But we've been lucky.
We love the good old days.
We've been kind of lucky.
What,
you said you guys would play here sooner or later.
June, I told you. We're going to set it up.
Yeah, we're going to get these guys to come down here and do a show here.
They are going to do a show here.
Absolutely.
I lived in this area for a long time. I got a lot of peeps in this area. Special shout out, North Tampa.
Mr. Wilson.
Yes, I know. I'm agreeing with you. Anyway, but until then, where can the listeners see you next?
I think it's May 19th, Sunday, at Courtside Grill. We're doing a thing to benefit the Wounded Warriors with Black Star Whiskey, Jaded, about five or six bands.
Great.
Sponsored by also NBA star Matt Geiger is going to be there, the Wine Trops. Bright House is sponsoring. It's a thing for the veterans. You know, we're honoring the Wounded Warriors. You know, and, you know, a lot of people take that for granted. You know, yeah, they're over there fighting. But when they come home, that's when they really need help a lot, too. So we're going to do a little benefit for the Wounded Warriors and people coming back.
We're going to try to raise some money.
That's a good thing.
Awesome. Yeah. That's good.
Yeah, we do a lot of things here at the Radio Bar and Grill. We always we always take care of veterans, kids, and animals.
Absolutely.
And the rest of us that can make it, we make it. But, you know, we do have a lot of benefits. So we've raised a lot of money since I've had this place open doing benefits and stuff. So it's a good thing. I mean, it always makes you feel good to give back.
Yep. It's all you can do sometimes these days, you know?
No, you know
right.
What? It's a bike away.
Absolutely. Actually, Craven, I'll turn it over to you. I mean, do you have anything you'd like to ask Jeff?
Listen, I know Jeff for a long time, and he's, you know, some of his buds that were back in the day, you know, and we were talking going all the way back to before Dive Bar Stalkers, if you know what I'm saying.
Yeah.
And back in the pirate radio days, so, you know, we know who you are, and we know what's going on. So what I did was, instead of just playing a regular playlist, as I loaded up two more of your songs here that aren't your brand new ones, but we're going to play those, and then we got some other special things that we got going on here with, what's your name, Kevin? we got this.
Smith for Heath Wilson.
My name is Felipe.
Heath Wilson.
and we're going to do some other special stuff. So
sorry.
Y'all hang around with us here. I'm going to load up, I think I loaded up.
Don't touch my fucking belly button, I'll kick your fucking ass.
What do you got? You got Rock the House there?
No, I got Rock the House after you got me running.
Yeah,
so, there you go. You got me running.
And you know what? I can pick them. If you don't believe that, listen to that.
You're right there, bro. That's a good one. Featured right, Lindsey Mercer on the harmonica.
There he is.
Right.
So, I'll tell you what, you guys rock. We love you. Here we go.
Appreciate it.
More music.
Well, listen now. If I gotta do this another day. If another thing doesn't go my way, you're gonna know just what I mean when I say it ain't what it seems. Oh, no. You got me running, you got me running, you got me running away.
excuse me, my boss, Mr. Craven Morehead, can you please approach the stage?
All right, we're getting Craven up here. Here we go, slowly but surely. All right, all
yes,
right.
Yes, boss, I'm here. Dina, Dina, stop.
No, stop. Seriously.
I'm here.
Craven, there's a couple things. Obviously, we announced that we're going to be handing out and talking about this evening. And the first thing we would like to give is we would like to thank you, first of all, not only for what you do for the local music scene or what you're trying to do for the local music scene here, along with your radio station, the FM station, the internet station, the radio bar and grill. We also want to thank you for allowing us to come in and invade pirate radio. And so we'd like to present you with this little plaque of appreciation. We want to thank you for all that you do and having us here tonight. Thank you so much.
It's an honor. I'm going to cry. No, actually, hey, let's rock and roll, baby. What do you say, huh? Come on.
Absolutely.
What this thing is all about, people, if you don't know, say thank you to Dina and to, what's your name, Kevin? Keith.
I'm Jose.
I want to say thanks to Keith and Dina for putting my bands in here and making it happen for me. But this whole thing's about rock and roll, baby. It's all about live music, local music. And when the FCC came down and raided me with the military, we were just doing nothing but local and live music on the radio station. It got raided. They took my freaking tower down, stole everything I own. I was famous for 15 minutes, and now I'm making the world famous here on the World Wide Web. I love y'all. Long live rock and roll.
Absolutely.
Thank you for this. I appreciate this. They'll be on the wall tomorrow, I promise. Or tonight, whichever. Thanks a lot, Kevin. I mean, Keith.
Can you see me?
I love you too, Dina. Thank you very much. And thank you, people, for being a part of this, making this happen for me, man, because this is my dream. Thanks.
Doing a great job, Craven. Thank you very
much. Rock on, people!
And, of course, we have another very special presentation. For those of you who know or don't know, I have the fortunate pleasure of sitting on the board of directors for a couple of different music organizations in the area, one of them being the Tampa Bay Music Scene Historical Society, which that one actually I founded. And the other one is actually the Tampa Bay Music Hall of Fame, which has actually been around since 99. However, it's been going through a lot of transitions before we actually started making any inductions or anything like that. And with what we're doing today with the pre-AMP show and tomorrow with the AMP show, it's to show that the Hall of Fame is actually ready to kick into gear, and there will be hopefully some major announcements in the future about induction ceremonies and this and that. However, I do have a special presentation to make this evening. Earlier this year, the Hall of Fame did, for the first time, put up its preliminary nominees for possible induction into the first class of the Hall of Fame. And we are here tonight to present Mr. Jeff Vitolo as being on the list. He is officially, with this certificate, it has been officially nominated for possible induction into the Hall of Fame. And, you know, Jeff's been around this scene for a long time. He has played in several popular bands in this area, has made, in my opinion, a difference in the scene. And it definitely gives me great honor to present him with this evening.
Dude, thank you very much. And the fact that I had a house four blocks from this place and used to tear up this town for many years, man, this means a lot to me right here. I started in a place just like this, and I'm back in a place just like this. You know what it is? A good place with some good people drinking beer and enjoying rock and roll. That's what I'm talking about. Thank you very much, man. And being in the Hall of Fame, all it means is you're just getting a little old, man. You know what I'm saying? Thank you, Keith. Thank you, Craven. Thank you,
my
Dina.
Pleasure.
Appreciate it. Thank you, Radio Bar and Grill. And I'm spreading the word around this place, man. All bands, you need to get over here. This place is cool. Can I say cool as fuck on the internet?
Yeah, you can say cool
this
as
place
fuck.
Is cool as
you
fuck,
can say
man.
Shit, fuck, damn, hell. You can say whatever you want.
And Dina, thank you very much. This is going in the spot where my Grammy was supposed to be, okay?
All right. Anyway, we're going to turn it back over here in a minute to Craven, put on a couple more tunes for you. Then hopefully we'll get back there again some more. Maybe hopefully we can get Jeff and the crew back there, talk a little bit more. In the meantime, we'll listen to some more music. And I think I'll eat some up some more time here since we're waiting. And anyway, I do want to thank everybody for tuning in. Those tuning in, whether it's on 102.1 FM or the internet, really appreciate you. Hope everybody comes out. Remember, this is all about AMP that's going on, the main event tomorrow at the Porpoise Pub in Seminole. We're going to have a lot of great bands for you playing out there. A lot of great surprises for you, some guest appearances. And anyway, of course, our sponsors for the event for tomorrow, Seminole Music and Sound, Extreme Earbrush Studios, Bay Area Band Source, KAM Music Publishing, Tampa Bay Music Scene, Historical Society, and the Hall of Fame. I want to thank Charlie Souza, the founder of the Hall of Fame, for everything. And we're going to get Craven back on here, maybe play a couple more tunes, I guess, and hopefully see, maybe get Jeff back in there and talk a little bit more, and the whole gang.
All right, thanks a lot there. Keith. Oh, yeah, Keith, yeah. All right. Good job, man. And I want to say it once again, thanks to KAM-BABS and all the local people here that work so hard to keep live music happening here in the Tampa Bay area. I'm committed to... And I promise to always keep that happening here. As long as I'm here at the Radio Bar and Grill, there's going to be a place where you can come down and hear local live talent that everybody really wants to hear. And especially original music. That's what I started with back in the 90s with the pirate radio station and what we're doing now. We're bringing it worldwide to all you listeners and all you viewers. I want to say thanks once again. Especially to Keith and Dina for putting all this stuff out. And if you get a chance, go out there and see the big show tomorrow because we get all the local bands playing out there at Porpoise Pub. And we'll have a lot more for you here at the Radio Bar and Grill every Friday and Saturday night, live music. And don't forget about Jam Night every Tuesday night. Tuesday night, we got great musicians, great bands coming up in here jamming and having a damn good time. That's what it's all about. And that's what we're doing here at the Radio Bar and Grill. This is WPRN Tampa, Florida, 102.1 FM. Stay tuned for more. We're going to play a little music for you now. Hopefully we can talk somebody into going back up on stage and playing some more live music. We'll see how that goes.
In the heat of the morning, in the eye of the sun, hear the wind stop blowing, see the holes in the gun.